Let's take a look at beta first, just because it has smaller numbers, so maybe that's a bit easier to reason about. Now, as we grow the input size, notice that we're growing the input size linearly. And as we grow it linearly, the time it takes beta also grows relatively linearly. So we double from 100 to 200, we roughly double. And as we triple from 100 to 300, well, we get roughly triple of the initial input size. 16 is pretty close to 18. So I'm going to go ahead and say that beta is linear. Now, alpha just explodes, right? At 100, well, it doesn't take a whole lot of time. In fact, it takes quite a bit less time than gamma. But at n equals 200, alpha is already in the hundreds of thousands. And then it gets even bigger and bigger very, very quickly. So I think it's reasonable to say that alpha has an exponential running time. Now, gamma might be a little trickier to see, but I think if we look at the input sizes relative to the running times in gamma, we can see that it looks to be polynomial. Now, to see this, let's take a look at n squared for these input sizes. N squared for 100 is 10 to the fourth, which is quite a bit bigger than gamma's running time. N squared for 200 is similarly much bigger than gamma's running time, and on and on. And n squared is really the lowest polynomial running time you are probably going to get that isn't linear. And it definitely dominates gamma, at least for the instances that we're looking at. So I would definitely say that gamma is polynomial in running time. For a more visual representation of this, let's draw a few graphs. Let's take a look at alpha first. Now, alpha is still very tiny at n equals 100. And relative to this graph, it's still very tiny here. Here, it's quite a bit bigger, but it's still, compared to 10 to the 13th, 10 to the 9th is actually pretty small. And then it's way up here for n equals 400. Let's just kind of draw an approximation to that. And this is not to scale, but it'll give you an idea for the shape of the graph, which is really what we're going for. For beta and gamma, we really just can't see them on this graph. They're so close to the x-axis here that they might as well just be right on top of it. So that doesn't really help us. So clearly, alpha is growing just unbelievably faster than both beta and gamma. So let's zoom in a bit and look at this again. All right, so now we're only going up to 10 to the fourth. So that makes gamma fairly easier to draw. At n equals 100, it's still pretty small. At 200, it's closer. And at 300, it's about halfway there. And then it gets about here. So let's go ahead and draw that. If we try to draw beta, we're still right about here. So it still grows much, much slower than gamma does. And so you can see that they're really in different classes because they're both just growing so much slower than alpha is. But beta similarly is growing just so much slower than gamma is. So they're definitely in different classes. And this is kind of a visual intuitive representation of why alpha is exponential, gamma is polynomial, and beta is linear.